Hello, my friends. This is Delta Blues Tips here. It's been a long time, but I've been ill for so long. I'm still ill. I haven't got there yet. And I'm sort of doing my own thing. So what I'm going to do now is hopefully make a return by doing something that's not too heavy, not too hard. I'm going to show you the technique from jumping from this string down to this one that I use. I've thought about many other guitar players, not just me. This is my way of doing it. So basically, we're going to be... But first, let's tell you my tuning. I've just tuned it down to E flat, which is what I always pretty much play it. It's like 3/4, 2 tuning, maybe slightly lower than that actually. So if you've got a tuner, well, if you want to get in tune with me, you'll obviously have to listen to this. I can't even think straight. That's me E flat or thereabouts. A flat or thereabouts again. All flats, remember. G. B. That's the E. So if we just turn this a bit, and I'll play you there. An E chord. Now I'll just play through this a little bit and let you hear what I've just made up this little ditty to keep this picking going. Hopefully it'll help you to keep it going. It's been a long time. Basically, we're going to mess around with it. We're going to make it slightly fancy. But I want to show you how to achieve that first bit. So if we zoom in, if I can remember how to do it, it's been that long since I've had a go. If we zoom in a bit, right, okay. We're playing it in an E chord. And we're going to use our little finger on that note. This, I'm going to go across like this. That's a bit of a stretch, but I'll explain that in a second. Okay. So I'm going to go. I'm going to just do that with my little finger like this. Then we're going to move into this, which is just those four strings. It's an A something. It could be a couple of different chords, but I'm just calling it partly an A. Basically because I don't know what it is really. This gives a nice softness to it. So we go. That's the first bit we're going to learn. Let's have a look now with this hand, what's going on. Well, you can see this. I can't really see it that much. I don't think I can. I'm going to have to slightly move this camera in. Sorry about that, folks. actually said oops. I can feel like you, Grant. And what I'm going to do is take my thumb across and first finger and thumb on the G and B. Now to achieve this sound, here I am, I'm over exaggerating this movement here with this hand, but what I'm doing is I'm relaxing the pressure and going in time with my other hand like this. And I'm pressing in as my thumb hits this E string, even though I'm not using these fingers on it, that's when I press in. See? These are the things most players won't bother explaining to you. And then those two. Let's go in a bit here. I'll put that back out, I don't think. That's better. And the more I bring this hand onto the strings, the more it'll deaden that sound. See? Or here, more like it. Got a little bit of put in. Doing there is I'm adding the little finger on the second fret on the B string. First I hit it like that, then I add the finger. Hear that sound? And this finger takes the open E string as this thumb crosses. Kill all the sound. That wasn't a successful experiment, that was it, because I need that note. That's that bit. That's the finger on me left hand going on, little finger. I'm going to do that stretch into the 4th fret middle finger. Sorry, that was the wrong note, I shouldn't have hit that open. But you've got to bear with me, and I'm still pretty much suffering a bit. Discs in my neck. Finger goes out to the 4th fret, back to the 2nd fret on the E string. Show you that this end. Let's move that out a bit there. Very manual this. Down at what we're doing there now. blues, as they say. This, as you can see, this first lesson is all about keeping that nice thing going. And the reason I'm using the E chord, by the way, is because it involves using all the strings. What I'm trying to do is give you an idea of picking beyond just going off like that, like using everything. You can see the difference in the sound that time, can't you? What I'm doing is sliding with my little finger from the second fret on the E string into the fourth fret. In the slide. Listen now for the slide. Okay, so there you go, and that is part one of, I haven't even got a title for this, but I think I'll call it Jumping One, Two, Three, Four, Three Strings. Jumping Three Strings in E. So hope you enjoyed it, let me know how it goes, and then, and part two will be coming up next.